The episode begins now.
All right. Yeah, so Adam's going to be making a coffee. So
I'm not making you coffee. I have cold brew to offer you. If you reject the cold brew, I'm not making you coffee.
I need a hot coffee.
I offer you a soda or a
hot day.
Hot toddy.
You're always complaining about how hot it is.
Hot toddy. I like hot coffee. It hits the system better.
It's a very hot day.
What, are you going to just like inject cold heroin into your veins? No, you heat that shit up, buddy.
I put it in a spoon.
I put it in the blast chiller.
You know what I'm saying? I like cold cum.
I was thinking about a bit where it's like something about how when fat people relapse, it's like there's no spoons in his house. It's like, oh no, is he doing heroin? It's like, no, it's ice cream.
Yeah,
it's all spoons.
I was trying to work on a bit about how like I want to be able to hate light skinned ass crackers.
Light skinned
like
ass
pale people.
White people.
Oh, you want to call pale people light skinned ass crackers?
I'm tired of these light skinned ass crackers. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
No one can get mad at that.
Northern Europeans.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Fucking Scandinavian ass, redbone ass crackers.
Fuck out of here. Nah. Yeah, yeah.
I need me a redbone cracker. Yeah, yeah. A ginger. You just start calling gingers red bones?
It's fucking redbone ass cracker. I'm tired of these light skinned ass, skin, gossamer skin looking like the sock they give you to try on shoes looking ass crackers. Fucking skin talking about half a millimeter thick with your light skinned cracker ass.
Oh, yes, bitch.
Ruining the beach.
With your little alabaster ass.
Reflecting your ass on everybody.
Mm-hmm. Yep, absolutely.
Bringing a whole fucking tent. Like you the Monster Energy, you know, sponsored whatever
tents.
Thing.
Oh, tents. Yeah.
Like you're a local. Uh-huh. My man got his own kiosk. Brought a whole circus tent for him and his light-skinned ass cracker family. That's what
good.
I'm going to be mad about.
I like
about.
That.
Also, another bit I'm working on about how you can get high off saying the N-word. That for white people, we get high. A lot of people know that.
They don't know
the reason
that,
we love
true.
Saying it so much is we get a little buzz.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
That's why we say it so much at home.
Mm-hmm. And we.
They all of us. And they took away the N-word from us.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
what's left? That's right, fentanyl.
Yeah,
opiates,
and that's what created the
and
opiate
that's the crisis.
Them
and
that's why
the
Donald Trump became president.
That's right.
So if you don't want Trump as president, you don't want a bunch of doped up white people voting for Donald Trump. Let us blast ends in public. I'm talking Boston Market. Just blast them. Just fucking
Boston
blast them.
Boston Market, huh?
Yeah.
You waiting for that fucking little rotisserie
Dog,
chicken?
It is on the menu. It's part of the ordering process. That's how you
put the N-word?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let me get the chicken pot pie, the Cambridge French fries. Oh, and the boo. What is it? You just say it? Oh, and I don't have to pay. I can just say it for free. So I can just keep saying it? Oh, this is great.
I'm going to go vote for a progressive candidate now, mm-hmm. now that I got that out of my system.
That's my free love movement. It's free the
free
N-word.
N?
Free the N-word.
The free N movement. Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude.
I'm telling you,
fun.
Man. You let us blast ends at KB Toys.
Yep.
Just going in there. Not,
out of
no,
business.
No child. I don't even have a child.
Absolutely.
Just
not.
Go in there blasting ends.
It's out of business.
Guess who I'm voting for? That's right. Hillary Clinton. Jim Webb. I'll give you Jim Webb.
Hell yeah, dude.
I'll vote for Kasich. John Kasich.
Kasich.
Dude.
Kasich goes in.
I
dude.
Blast two ends a day. John Kasich. Four ends a day. Jim Webb.
Okay.
Unlimited ends a day. Hillary Clinton.
Whoa.
Wow.
Maxine Waters. I'm writing in Maxine Waters. If every single word I say is full bore blasted in. Like I'm trying, like I got a mining company and we're going through the mountains using the N-word. Blasting the rocks with the N-word. Until we get to that sweet natural gas.
Hell yeah, dude. Then you just huff that.
Yeah.
Scientists
say it's better for the environment than fracking, but is the new N-blasting method of finding natural gas bad for society?
Dude, there's a lot of
I don't understand how it works, to be honest with you. I just know it's wrong. Look, I can't tell you, and I know that seems like liberal bullshit,
I know, I'm
right?
a physicist.
That I shouldn't just be opposed to a type of drilling. But I'm pretty sure screaming the N-word at rocks... That can't be good. It's not good for the communities. It's not good for the people that live in those towns.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I was out of work for years, and when this happened, I just knew my calling was about. I've been calling my nephew that for free,
mm-hmm.
and so I figured I'd do it now, and I get a health insurance plan out of it.
But the results are catastrophic. Take a look at Centralia, Pennsylvania, a town overcome by over N-word usage. It's unlivable now, even by white people, because it's too racist.
They live 1,000 feet below sea level now.
Every time somebody put up a building, I just yell the N-word. Yeah, it's fun watching it go down. Yeah.
They blast.
They're calling it N-11. And it's the greatest tragedy since the real 9/11.
Damn, dude. Yeah, we should harvest N-word technology, clean N-word technology. Mm-hmm.
That's like...
Would there be dirty and clean?
Right.
ER and A?
That's like a deleted scene from Independence Day. Like the aliens come, and then Bill Pullman's like, I know how to handle this.
On three, the whole world has a secret. They're like,
there's the general that's like, let's call him the N-word. Let's call him the N-word right now. Sir, I've been in this army for 52 years, and I'll tell you the answer is calling those aliens the N-word. Let's use the N-word on them.
Why do you think we lost NAM? Yeah, they wouldn't let me scream
just
the N-word.
Let us do our damn job, sir. Let us do our job. They use the N-word at the aliens. They're like, it has no effect. At 12 o'clock tonight, the combined military forces of the world will point megaphones at the mothership and unleash our most powerful weapon against the aliens. For today is our Independence Day.
There you go.
Our dependence on the N-word.
Damn. Very nice. We should end the episode there, man. Yeah.
I'll tell you, dog.
Independence Day, brother.
That's what the red
phone's for.
We're
going to do 4 o'clock. I said, let's do noon. I'm fired up. Noon. Imagine how much better this would be if you got me that fucking coffee.
Whew. You sound like you're pretty on all cylinders right now.
It's going to fade.
Maybe removing the coffee from you, it makes you run on anger.
No, I had one. Mm-hmm. I had one. Oh, okay. You mean taking it away, offering it, and then taking it away?
So you requested one for the power of requesting it.
That's the caffeine.
What's in the news? Long after vile hate crime, tending flame to fight racism. I don't know what that means. Oh, Jasper, Texas. That's no good. That's the most racist town in America.
Is that the dragging?
Either Jasper or Vider. One of the two.
Is that where they did the dragging?
I think Vider is the one where they did the dragging.
Yeah. Vider?
Yeah, Vider, Texas.
Gary Vider, Texas?
Mm-hmm.
It's just the...
Vider just sounds like an evil southern town.
Yeah.
Sounds fake. Sounds
so
like
does Jasper.
Vader.
Sound like Darth Vader.
Darth Vader.
I love Darth Vader. I was ashamed to find out that his voice was a Mufasa. They used a goddamn Mufasa to do the voice of Darth Vader. Because he was my favorite character. The father that comes back. I can relate to that.
Fuck. Damn. Yeah, I'm running. I'm drinking coffee again, you know? Because I got to get back on the East Coast sketch. Mm-hmm. I was on that damn West Coast. I'm sleeping in, dude. I need some. What can I do to jumpstart my productivity? Bring me back into the fold.
You can start.
What do you guys think?
Jacking off first thing.
You think so? Wouldn't that make you sleepy?
Does it? Do you go to back
do you
to
jack
bed
off
after
in
that?
The morning?
I used to, no. But I don't anymore.
Why did you used to?
I don't know. Why
get
not?
The day going?
Yeah.
Nice.
Jacking off first thing always.
I rarely wake up hard anymore.
Really?
Yeah.
I
wake up in the middle of the night
hard. Wake up hard. Yeah.
No, I very rarely wake up hard. That's this stop like a couple years ago.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. I feel like I'm only hard in the morning. That's when I got that real nice one ready to go.
Yeah.
I like to fuck in the morning. There's less pressure.
No, not me.
Yeah,
I'm never
pee
really.
Boner.
I'm not really ever hard.
You're never hard?
Never.
What about when you're having sex?
Not particularly.
You're just hitting them with that fucking...
No, I kind of fuck like I'm packing last minute for a trip. Just jam all the clothes into a backpack.
Yeah, I like
you ready to go?
Control.
All right. Yeah.
Just keep
and
it
then
there.
I put on my neck pillow and read my Dan Brown novel. And that's how I fuck.
That's good, bro. It's important
Ooh,
to have
what
neck support.
Paintings were magical. Dan Brown, the magical paintings.
Jesus' magic painting.
Yeah. This painting of Jesus is actually magic. It's black girl magic.
That would be so powerful. A Tyler Perry, not even Tyler Perry. What's the black lady that Ava DuVernay?
No, there's a...
Isn't that her name?
Yeah, that might be her.
It is. Her slash Dan Brown.
Uh-huh.
Black magic, dark magic.
Dan dark chocolate brown. Or damn brown.
Damn brown. Damn brown.
How brown that guy? He damn brown.
Did you guys see that movie with like Oprah and Reese Witherspoon where they're wearing purple and blue lipsticks?
Legally
the color
black.
Purple?
Legally black.
It's about a black woman that becomes a lawyer.
Hell yeah, she gets her permit.
Mm-hmm.
She's the first allowed to be black person in Vader, Texas.
What was that movie, the Ken Burns documentary, Unforgivable Blackness?
What?
What?
Is that real?
No, that's Unforgivable?
No, it's Unforgivable Blackness.
It's that's
about
a fucking
Jackie Robinson or something.
Oh, shit. Nice.
Was that the name he gave it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Why are you so?
Because all of the other names of his stuff.
I mean,
are
I used to call
thing.
It Unforgivably Black. I would fuck up and call it that, which sounds worse than Unforgivable Black.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Because it sounds like you're deciding to be a level of black.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You've deemed something too black to be forgivable.
Yeah.
That's got to be a quote from someone, right? Unforgivable blackness. Ken Burns didn't just come up with that.
Yeah,
off the top.
No. It's something. It's from someone.
I looked up recently.
Stupid ass blacks. The Ken Burns story. Yeah, yeah.
These dumbass light skinned ass. Ken Burns is light skinned.
Yeah, he's a light skinned ass
is.
Cracker.
Mm-hmm. He looks even like though he has 11 that, years old.
Even though he has that fucked up wig.
Damn.
Is it a wig?
Look at this. Just let that baby die. Look at all the science going on.
No, man. That
baby
doesn't want to die.
Look at all the wires it's got.
That baby wants to grow up and fuck.
It's got spark plugs.
Yeah, she's a little
what
fucking robot.
What is that,
robot.
Like the natal ICU or something?
Damn, I hope I never have a kid. It's going to be so fucked up if I do.
Yeah, it really will be.
Just every disease.
Yeah. Everything you've ever mocked.
Just, yeah.
Just a club-footed, retarded trans baby.
I feel like all...
Kill me. Kill me, please. Faggot Mullen died. Yeah.
Nintendo 64 Mullen. The baby that...
This is called An Affront to God.
Okay. Not only was the kid retarded, he named it after Nintendo.
Damn. I would name my baby GameCube if I had to pick a system. That's the system that meant the most to me, I would
GameCube?
Say. I think GameCube.
Really?
I played the best gaming years of my life on a GameCube.
Crazy Taxi.
I think probably PlayStation 2 was the best console. Either play. Actually, you know what? Honestly, Xbox 360 was like, that was the
Halo?
No, I was never got into Halo, but like there was so many because I like didn't play video games for like 7 years or whatever, and then when I was in my early twenties, I got a PlayStation or an Xbox 360.
You played Call of Duty?
Yeah, I would play Modern Warfare all the time.
All day.
And I remember playing that. And I'm like, oh, they figured out video games.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is
it. My friend had
it'll never get better than this.
My friend had to do 6 years of college because of Call of Duty.
Yeah,
yeah, he failed out of a year and a half. Three semesters.
Modern Warfare 2 was like, goddamn! I played that game so fucking much.
Yeah,
because if you get 25 kills in a row, you can call a nuke and end the game.
Oh, rocks.
Yeah, I think I remember.
It was
that.
Just so much of like just you know,
trying to get that 25th kill.
Well, you get to 7, you can call in the Harrier jet.
Hell yeah!
And then the Harrier jet, you get 4 kills. You get to 11, you call in the chopper gunner.
Yeah,
and then you come
bitch.
In, you just light people up with that chopper gunner. Just fucking wasting dudes from an Apache a mile away. Yeah. What a great feeling. And then you hope while you're using, because you do it from a laptop, right? And then so somebody can come fuck your ass up on the laptop.
So you're just fucking typing on the game?
No, well, it's the screen, but like your character just fucking,
just stays
your like guy just stays on a laptop. And someone finds you and ices you while you're in the chopper gunner, you're dead.
That's got to feel good for you specifically to be killing using a laptop.
Me?
That's that combines your two great... You're posting and murdering at the same time. Mm-hmm. It's a form of directly... Instead of hurting their feelings, you're literally killing them.
That's right.
Yeah. What if they fucking weaponized fucking posts, dude? And the government called you.
Weaponized
like,
what?
We need you to post. They weaponized posts.
Posting?
Yeah.
That'd be pretty cool.
You need to own foreign leaders?
In the dark future, where posting is illegal.
We need someone to draw a dick on Garfield.
It can't be done.
I've been in prison
for 25 years.
Yeah.
I'm just completely jacked.
Working out your fingers specifically. Your fingers are fucking ripped, dude.
Yeah.
The second they're allowed near a fucking keyboard, you're going to do memes.
That's right. That is damn right.
We need someone to draw Odie with a pussy and then fuck it.
What if you could draw things and then fuck them, and they come to life and you fuck them?
Facebook is watching you. The social media giant is aggressively spreading its facial recognition tools, even as it confronts heightened security from regulators and legislators in Europe and North America.
Nice.
There's going to start to be, like, terrorist attacks, domestic terrorist attacks on tech companies specifically.
Mm-hmm. Who's still on Facebook?
I don't know. Are you?
No. I mean, I have a page, but I never check it.
Yeah.
I feel like it's moved to old people now. My mom's
people,
on it.
Yeah.
Her friends.
Yeah.
There's a Greek town. There's a Greek town group where it's all like 65-year-old people that are like, "Remember when there was no blacks here?" Just like they're just reminiscing about. Greek town's so funny because it's like they're like, "All these Mexicans are stealing our neighborhood." It's like the neighborhood was a German neighborhood before Greeks came in. We just stole it from those fucking krauts.
Right.
But, you know.
And before that.
I mean, that was like every city in
Native
America.
Native American.
Nah, Baltimore was always not a trace of Native American.
Didn't?
Nah. Then you just,
none.
Then you just stay away.
Yeah. East Coast just has like Native American names.
Mm-hmm.
It's never.
Is the Chesapeake Native American?
Chesapeake's Native American, I think.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you know, like, all of New York is fucking... Manhattan is a native word.
Canarsie is Native American. That's a tribe. Yeah.
Jamaica is a Native American word, actually.
Whoa,
They're two different... Jamaica, the island, is a completely different, like, root... Like, the origin of that name
they came
is
up
completely
that
different from Jamaica.
Jamaica,
that's
Queens?
Wild.
Get the fuck out of here.
Just
that is wild.
Completely separate. Uh-huh. Yeah. No relation whatsoever. And then, you know, a bunch of Caribbean people.
That's a good...
Yeah, yeah.
That's a good hacky comedy mashup. Rasta Native American guy. You could do that.
Go ahead, do it.
Take that for a spin.
That's all you, man. Let's hear it.
How?
Let's hear the professional comedian Adam Friedland riff out the bit that he came up with.
I didn't come up with it.
Yeah, you got it.
No,
man.
I'm sure
go
you
ahead.
Came up with it, but, you know,
my
do your job.
Come on.
Do your job.
No, go ahead. You
go
got
ahead.
It.
Do your job.
No, we believe in you, man.
We believe in you.
I'm rubbing your shoulder. I'm rubbing Adam's shoulders. I'm getting ready.
Stop getting really good massages.
Thank you.
All right.
Listening.
How?
Lively up yourself. How?
Lively up yourself.
Smoke weed. Smoke weed every day.
How do Native American people see?
So it's like it's rain daggering where they're aggressively dry humping a woman.
See,
and then
there.
It's raining. There's a thunderstorm happening. They're like, "Fuck a horda man!" You know, and then the maze grows.
It would have been easier to do the
You should have done
Jamaican
voice.
Accent with the Native American. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, that's good.
Well, hey, man, you'll get your groove back. You'll remember how to be a comedian someday.
I'm getting it back
could have been
slowly.
A thing in your early 20s while you're relevant. Now you're an old man.
No,
you know, we all burn out. We all fade away.
The situation is not as.
The flame is extinguished.
Not as dire as you're putting it.
You know, we all lose sight of ourselves, and time goes on, and then instead of being a guy that had some sort of creative edge, you're just working retail. You're 46 years old.
Yeah.
You say, I used to be on a podcast or whatever.
I'm not going
to
work.
Child support to some Russian woman and her black husband.
Dasha wouldn't say that.
We didn't say it right. You assumed
you
Dasha.
Assumed. I didn't say that.
You just happened to say a Russian woman.
Yeah.
Mm.
Her black husband, and you have to you're paying child support to your son, who's also black.
Yeah, it's a John Redcorn situation.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, you guys are actually still together, but you have a black son.
Yeah.
You're like, "Oh, did you adopt?" No. He's just black as shit. He doesn't even look mixed.
Yeah, that's funny. That's pretty funny.
He's like, Dad, can I borrow the keys to go hang out with my friends?
Dad, I gotta go to Shabbat dinner.
Dad, me and my friends are trying to go to Bojangles Chicken. Dad, it's me, your son. Adam Jr.
It's me, Adam Jr., Dad.
It's me, Adam Jr. I'm 11 years old. Mm-hmm. I'm in the first grade. Damn, we learning about the Holocaust in school? It's crazy that people did that to us. Jewish people like us. Eastern European Jews like ourselves.
Dad, can I have a Magic City themed bar mitzvah?
We were reading about reading about Anne Frank, who was one of us. I don't know how, because you know I'm 6'7". I don't know how I would have hid it from them. Dad.
Oh, damn, Dad. I just want to throw on some wood. That Woody Allen boy crazy, mm-hmm. Dad.
Dad, how do I fit out my mom's pussy? Oh, we were spread out by somebody else before I was born? Because, you know, I was a 17-pound baby.
That's just true.
Dad, yeah. how come your wrist is the same size as my thumb? Dad, what come?
Okay, so guys, if you're wearing underwear, go ahead and take them off.
Yeah, take them off.
Take your underwear off. Shit those underwears off your body.
That's right.
Because we got a new underwear for you. Oh, Mack yes, Weldon underwear. You can go check out at MackWeldon.com.
Mm-hmm.
The premier outlet for premium, simple shopping, premium fabrics, and smart design. It's a simple shopping experience. You'll love it. You'll love it. Wear the underwear and fucking eat it. Let your dog eat them up after you get a little
cum all
pussy
over
blood on the
that's
front.
Right. Let your dog eat that pussy blood.
Your dog eats pussy blood.
Every dog eats pussy blood. It's nothing special. There's nothing
I
special trained about
her.
Your dog.
No, it's a
but
train.
There's something special about Mack Weldon underwear, which is what we're talking about right now, not your dog.
Right.
I bought underwear there myself. It's one of the easiest shopping experiences I've ever had in my life, you know? When you go there, they put all the underwear up on the auction blocks. So you examine their physique. You
no,
know, you
I don't
see.
Think you're thinking of something else.
Well, I'm
else.
Thinking of a different purchasing experience I had. Well, Mack Weldon, very similar to that. The power you feel.
Yes.
Subjugating those underwear.
No. Different angle. Take a different angle.
Yeah. Don't.
Remember we were talking about putting it in your bitch's pussy? Let's go back to that.
Okay. So, Mack Weldon underwear, very, very smart design, premium fabric, simple shopping experience. Love those underwear.
Anti-motherfucking microbial.
Anti-microbial. They got a silver line of antimicrobial shirts and underwear that'll suck all the sweat off your glistening body as you're out there in the fields working hard.
No.
A lot of people work in fields. What field are you in? I'm in the entertainment field.
Ah, okay. All right.
That's
all
a different type of field. That's where the term field comes from. That's where the term field comes from.
No, that's not true.
I work out in the software field. That is a field you can
so, use promo code.
Use promo code Cumtown, capital C, lowercase U, or all capital letters, CUMTOWN, all one word, to receive 20% off your order. And check them out. But we have to do mention the antimicrobial line of underwears and shirts. They suck all the sweat off your body, and they look good no matter what you're doing. You know, going out during your day, doing a podcast, you look good, feel good. They got crew necks, all sorts of shit.
All the good shit.
They do have good stuff there, for real. I know we joke around a lot on this podcast.
Yeah,
if
no,
I'm
but
gonna
serious.
Say anything sincerely ever in my life.
What's
it's
that?
Please buy those underwear. Please buy them. Do it.
Please buy them.
For the love of God. I'm trying to afford numerous abortions right now.
Oh, yeah. We got to stack up on
I went on a little bit of a tear.
Did you?
Yes. I impregnated probably 17 different women after the show last week. And the only way I can kill those children is if you buy those underwear.
That's great.
So go check them out. And we're back.
And we're back. Damn. So, anyway,
Dad.
Black Sun.
Yeah. We're Dad. All right, Dad,
keep
I was.
Going. Keep going with it.
Not.
I would be proud to have
did
a
you know? Did you know Step Brothers?
You'd probably be a very good father to your cuck created son.
You would be, actually.
When Dasha cuckolds you with a...
Dasha's not going to...
With like a Beetlejuice-sized black guy. But then he's still got the genes in him to produce a large boy.
Sure.
So the real father comes by and he's like, where my son at? He lives outside. And she's like... Roscoe, remember, you're not supposed to say he's your son around my husband, Adam. He's like,
I got trash.
She just fucked some midget trash eating black guy. That's who she did.
I got cucked by. I got trash stuck in my dick. I got a bunch of trash down my dick. Dick out at the bus stop. I try to hide in the trash. When a bus come by, the motherfucker driver bus be laughing at me.
Now, okay, I'll suck your dick. Just shut up. I'll just fuck one more time.
Suck my dick, bitch. Suck my dick. Oh, feels good. Feels real good.
God, just 5'1".
Can you imagine? Can you imagine coming home? God, your wife is fucking Doodle Juice Green.
Adam's like coming home from his job at, I don't know, Boston Market.
A guy that can't do math.
Yeah.
Oh, I feel good.
It's a football sized dick.
It's on my dick.
I just wanted to be.
She's like, Adam, I have the house all afternoon. I told you that. Come on, Adam Jr. Dad, where are we going? Dad, who's that guy? Dad, who is that guy? Don't worry about it, Adam.
Who's that little boy mom is having sex with?
Oh, God.
God damn. That's so fucking stupid. Would be so funny.
It would be.
Yeah, that would.
It would be very funny for us.
For all of us. For the three of us.
I mean, dude, for the three of us. You're going to get cheated on. It's a little 5'1".
Beetlejuice from the Howard Stern show. Semi-retarded. That guy's full retard.
Just a 32-year-old crack baby.
Yeah.
We'll bring that mouth over here, Ben. I got trash on my dick. You got clean that trash on my dick.
Just living in a trash can like Oscar the Grouch. One of those little rectangular ones next to the bus stop.
Yeah, a little roomier.
With the rectangular ones that have like the top on it that's like elevated.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
He just pokes his head out, dude. Mm-hmm. Where's that buck going?
Just bring that ass over here.
Put your pussy in the trash. Let me suck your pussy.
Like, Dasha, why is there trash in your pussy?
Don't.
Why is there CVS wrappers coming out of your asshole?
Is this a receipt?
A receipt, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Adam, don't ask me questions.
Dad, one more meal at you.
Let's go shoot free throws, Adam Jr.
Yeah,
There's no time to worry.
Adam
about
comes
this.
To do the podcast and he's like, everyone's posting Roscoe's home address on the Reddit. And it's like, I care about the guy.
They just drop a pin to the trash can.
I don't want people harassing Roscoe. Because he's upset, and then Dosh is upset, and then I have to hear
Roscoe.
Roscoe's the guy.
The guy that's cucked. Fucking her?
Your son is Adam Jr.
Your son is Adam Jr. Roscoe's the guy that lives in the trash can outside of the outside of the Blockbuster.
That's having sex with your wife.
He's fucking your wife.
But you care about him.
Yeah.
Because you're a good guy.
I have to say.
You care about him a lot.
I do care. Yeah. I have to say the image of the lid opening slightly and then just you see two white eyes.
Yeah, yeah. With his fucked up teeth.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where you going with
very
with
yellow
that
eyes. Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Just yellow ass eyes.
Just bug eyed.
Yeah.
With that.
I've been drinking Wild Irish Rose in that trash can for a week and a half.
Roscoe's a good guy.
He's a good guy, man. He doesn't know. He doesn't know what he's doing.
Dad, why mom in a bad mood? Well, your uncle was arrested for stealing tricycles. So she's been, she gets cranky.
Oh, fuck.
Because as you know, my penis fell off when I gave birth to you. She had her uterus surgically implanted into my body.
Into my balls.
As to not ruin her pussy for your uncle.
It would be my honor to seahorse for my wife.
So that I had to give birth to a 17-pound black man.
Out of my scrotum.
Out of my penis.
Out of my penis.
It ripped your ass, too.
Your penis and ass off.
You're just fucking... You're asshole from your nuts to the top of your back.
Yeah. I've said this before, guys, but...
But?
I'm your muse, and you have to accept it.
Do you guys know Step Brothers came out 10 years ago?
Damn. That's a feel good old. Movie. Step Brothers came
Isn't
out.
Isn't that wild? That is, that
Why?
Is a legit.
Where did you,
I feel
get that
old.
From?
I was reading.
You
someone
feel
came
like
out.
That's a new movie? That's, 10 years makes complete
10 years
sense.
Is long, dude.
We're Adam,
old.
That's like
We're gonna die.
That's like some consolation. You know, you get down about like.
Yeah, I know.
The way things are going.
Yeah, yeah,
Stop
yeah.
stupid.
Stop,
but
Stop
also,
really
it's
that's
like,
not the consolation.
Step Brothers was already 10 years ago.
Yeah, yeah. That's,
that's, that's wild.
We'll
fuck
dead.
You guys for being dickheads.
We'll
this
be
is,
dead
that
before
is insane.
We know it.
Yeah, it's probably 10 years old.
That's
yeah.
wild that it was 10 years ago. You guys are
it's,
fine
it's
with that?
It's really not. If you told me it was 13, 14 years ago, I'd be like, yeah, that makes sense. That's
no.
I feel like that movie came out in 2006.
No, it came out 2008.
Yeah,
2008,
we were in college.
Which is 10 years
yeah,
ago.
Yeah,
that's
I was in
that's
college.
That's wild.
Bro. It was a long time ago.
Yeah,
it
was a long time
that
ago.
It feels weird. When's the last thing Will Ferrell's made?
It's a Farrelly Brothers.
That
movie,
The
right?
House?
No,
it's not.
It's him and the guy who did Anchorman. What's the director that he works with?
Adam McKay.
Adam McKay.
Yeah.
Who also did The Big Short, which is the name of my dick.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know what the Farrelly Brothers have been up to.
Come and dumber.
Ooh, that's good. One's dumb, one's horny.
One's one's
come dumb. And dumber.
Yeah, it's like I don't know, Lloyd. How are we gonna get this briefcase back to that bitch? And Lloyd's just like, he's just coming the whole movie.
Yeah, it's a diarrhea scene, but it's cum.
I told you guys right. I cried when he gave the blind kid that bird when I was like a little kid and seeing that movie for the first time made me cry.
Really?
You're a liar, dude.
I was really sad.
Do you
have
a LaCroix?
Yeah.
Can I get one of those?
Yeah.
I'll get it.
I'll get your drink.
You can get it. I'm not going to take that away from you. Cheer up. Get some fucking confidence
back. I'm just hungover, guys. It's not even the confidence.
You need to get your confidence back, though. I'm tired of this.
And, well,
it's just,
I know
what
helps.
I'm fucking tired of it.
Talking about his girlfriend becoming his wife and then cheating on him with a trash midget.
No, that was a good bit. Honestly, that was a good bit. I'm not upset about that at all.
Adam, where are Roscoe's Butterfingers? No, he had a bag of Butterfingers sitting on the...
That would be
I don't
so.
Know.
I may have had one. I don't know. He slaps you.
Yeah.
He's getting beaten by a 5 foot one crackhead black man.
Where are my Snickers? I thought you said they're Butterfingers. You know he doesn't know how to read. He doesn't know the difference between Butterfingers and Snickers.
long live Roscoe.
Roscoe's doing Stern at 3 o'clock. I have an audition. What are you doing? I'm watching Filmstruck.
You got hungover? Did you get fucked up last night?
I got pretty fucked up after the show last night.
Shouts out to everyone who came out to the show, by the way.
And happy birthday, Jonah, once again.
Yeah, shout out to Jonah. Happy birthday.
Our DJ for Funny Mom.
Shout out to all the different types of ladies that came out.
Oh,
big
yeah.
bitches, small bitches, white bitches,
the whole
black
gamut
bitches,
of bitches.
Black bitches,
we
dark
did have
bitches,
a bunch of
bitches,
ladies.
Fat bitches.
We also had another...
Titty bitches, ass bitches.
I was pleased
bitches.
To see that we had
bitches.
A...
vagina bitches.
Hard pussy ass.
Eyelid ass Chinese bitches. Eyelids all pulled back.
Hell yeah. Cross eyed.
All
bitches.
The kind of bitches.
Mm-hmm. Bitches that love fucking durians, that weird little fruit.
Durian bitches. Dragon fruit bitches. Pomegranate bitches. Papaya bitches.
Ooh, papaya bitches.
Kiwi bitches.
You're just naming
mango
fruits?
Bitches. Banana bitches. Strawberry bitches.
Bitches
blueberry
that love sawdust.
Bitches, mulberry bitches, blackberry bitches, raspberry bitches, sawdust bitches, Home Depot bitches, plumbing supply bitches, grout and tile bitches, math bitches, math blaster
bitches,
PC bitches, Macintosh bitches, software bitches,
HVAC repair bitches,
HVAC bitches, wallpaper bitches, wainscot bitches, floorboard bitches. OSB-ass bitches.
Bitches that own
bitches.
Trampoline stores.
Trampoline-ass bitches. Spring-ass bitches. Lawn and garden supply bitches. Medicine cabinet bitches.
You know
just
that kind
of
bitch.
Just naming Home Depot.
It's just a schizophrenic rapper. Yeah. It's a 4.5 hour long intro to a song.
This one goes out.
Pan-American-ass bitches.
Mm-hmm.
Bowling trophy bitches.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Safety glass bitches.
Ribbons.
L.A. bitches gear ass ribbons. Bitches. Dial tone bitches.
Mm-hmm.
Movie phone
watch,
bitches.
Watch the movie Hairspray.
Hairspray bitches. Fat bitches. Ricky Lake bitches.
Yeah, Ricky Lake. Ricky
Lake. Yeah.
I do like free associating, but with bitches,
but with
at
bitches,
the end of every word.
Yeah. It feels good.
Yeah. I guess Freud would approve of that, too. Mm-hmm. That's what Freud, he had people come in his office. Yeah,
that's what his
like,
book
right,
was about.
Spit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You got two things. You either do this or you jerk off the picture of your mom on cocaine.
Freud used to make Freudian. People cipher. Pass
bum,
the mic.
Bum, bum, ba-dum. Bum, 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 ba-dum.
LaCroix, bitches.
Yeah, thank you, everyone came out. We should also just say in the middle of the show that we are hitting the road as a unit.
Obama
August
bitches.
12th, we're in motherfucking...
Baltimore.
At the Auto Bar,
we
Baltimore.
Haven't posted that on Twitter yet, have we?
No. Yeah. Also, so. Buy tickets for Caroline's. I'm at Caroline's. They're bitching at me because tickets aren't selling.
Yes, buy tickets. Go see Nick at Caroline's.
9, 10, 11, Caroline's. You go to the Caroline's website. Look through the schedule. Find me.
In a
it's
month.
Also,
got...
it's on my Instagram bio.
Yeah, go buy that shit.
I posted the Australia stuff on Twitter.
But also the
That's
Cleveland Boston
now.
Tour.
And then
we're
Cleveland,
in Cleveland
Boston.
Sunday the 1st. September 1st.
September.
And, or I'm sorry, Sunday the 2nd. And then we are in Boston the next day, the 3rd. So please buy tickets to both of those. Ticket links are up. And then I'm coming to fucking Chicago.
Chicago bitches.
Chicago bitches.
Cleveland bitches.
But
Boston.
Before that, Charlotte, I'm going to Charlottesville to
Charlotte
avenge.
Charlotte bitches. Ville bitches.
To avenge. To take out the cops.
Charlottesville?
Charlottesville. The yeah. 17th,
a
Friday.
I'm going to drive a Prius through a bunch of Nazis.
Yeah, that'll
run
show
over
them.
A bunch of Nazis with a Prius.
That's right. No, I'm getting a fucking Vespa, dude.
Yeah.
I'm about to fuck them up on armored ass.
Yeah,
Vespa.
I actually have a biodiesel Prius that runs off pussy juice. And I make it myself. I've trained my penis to make pussy juice. Instead of coming at
how much of an ally am I?
I come pussy juice now.
That's how I'm stopping Donald Trump. Is my penis doesn't get hard anymore. It gets wet.
I just have a little soaked up nub. My clit-sized dick gets wet as fuck.
Take that, Trump bitches. Bush bitches. Clinton bitches. Bush 1 bitches. Reagan
it looks like
bitches.
Someone's
Carter
always
bitches.
Basting my cock with baby oil.
Shrinking my
Ford
dick
bitches.
Trump.
LBJ. Nixon bitches. LBJ bitches.
Mm-hmm.
Kennedy bitches.
Woodrow Wilson ass bitches.
Eisenhower bitches.
Mm-hmm. John Quincy Adams bitches.
Yeah, Truman bitches.
Wilford Brimley.
It was before Truman.
George Grover Cleveland.
No.
Before Truman was Roosevelt.
Wilson. Yeah, right. FDR. Mm-hmm.
FDR.
Then prior to that was...
And then Truman took over and dropped the bomb, baby.
You're right. So FDR...
Before that, was
before
it Coolidge?
That, either Coolidge or Wilson.
Before
no,
FDR...
Hubert Humphrey.
Hoover.
Hubert Humphrey.
Hoover. Yeah, Hoover.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, Herbert
it's
Hoover.
Hard to go backwards.
I can Forwards maybe go backwards. Is,
we're doing it right now,
I used to be into presidents.
Okay, yeah,
so
that makes
do
sense.
It.
Yeah.
Well, it's Washington, Adams, Jefferson,
you're going
Adams.
Front ways.
Yeah.
Adams,
no, no, no. Let's
Madison,
not go front
ways. Madison.
We got Pierce.
McKinley? No.
At
some point.
Buchanan.
Buchanan. Was
there's
he the
two,
gay one?
There's two Buchanans.
Buchanan was before Lincoln.
Yeah.
He was 15.
William Henry Harrison, that motherfucker that died.
That
from,
one's like six
he
or seven.
Died in a,
Zachary
a month.
Taylor is in there.
Zachary
near
Taylor
yeah, yeah,
Thomas.
Yeah.
James K. Polk.
That's right.
Yeah. That guy didn't like Indians.
Yeah.
Andrew Johnson.
Johnson's like
he
what?
Didn't like Indians.
12.
Andrew Johnson was after Lincoln. He's 17.
No.
Yes.
No. Yeah, you're
yes.
right. Who
and
am I
he got
of?
Impeached,
Hamilton.
Right?
No, Hamilton
was
Hamilton,
never the president.
Not Hamilton. Who am I thinking of that
Hamilton
didn't
is
like
$10 bill.
Who the fuck is Andrew?
Who are you thinking about?
Andrew Jackson.
Andrew Jackson.
He's Andrew like, Jackson was like 8 or 9.
Yeah, he
yeah,
was in
right?
there somewhere.
Yeah. He was,
there was a, there was
he
a
I memorized
like
the all
Indians
of them,
too.
I remember at one point. But
when I was like in fourth grade.
Right, but
yeah.
I did it in chunks of 8.
Mm. That's so how
I,
you
I
did it?
Yeah, I did it in...
I used
that
to...
It wouldn't be that hard. We're only, what, 45?
45, yeah. It's not difficult.
Yeah.
This tricky one, because who's the guy that was president, and then was it Chester A. Arthur was president, and then someone else was president, and then he was
no,
president
no, that
again?
Was Cleveland.
Cleveland, yeah. Yeah. Grover Cleveland.
Taft, fat-ass Taft. Let's not forget about
Taft
him.
Taft was right before Teddy Roosevelt.
That's right.
Yes.
So,
that's
yeah,
right.
It's Coolidge, Taft, Roosevelt.
Coolidge was that far
no.
back? No, Coolidge was after
no, Teddy Roosevelt. No, no, no.
Teddy,
Coolidge,
yeah.
Coolidge was after Teddy.
So it's Teddy, Coolidge, Taft. No.
No, I don't fucking know.
Coolidge was like in the 20s, right?
I don't know.
Who cares?
Who gives a shit?
Fuck the presidents.
Fuck the presidents. Trump, 1,000 years.
Mm-hmm.
Forever Trump.
Trump 44.
Did you hear that shit he said about Elton John?
No, what'd he say?
He was just
an extremely low-T individual.
He was just like...
President Trump's selection of Judge Brett M. Kavanaugh. What do we think about Kavanaugh?
Kavanaugh, he's going to get rid of abortion.
Yeah. Roe v. Wade's about to get fucked in the ass, I guess. That sucks.
But see, these are things I don't really care about.
Abortion,
gay rights don't matter.
Yeah. For some reason. Yeah.
I mean, I agree that you should have them. I believe in a woman's right to choose, and I believe gay people should get married. But, like, does that affect me? No, not really.
Yeah.
So I really don't. It's not like I'm like, what are we going to do? I'll be fine. You know?
You're cool. Yeah, okay. No,
and ultimately, it's a dog world out there.
That's right. You know, the less rights they have, the better it is for you.
Well, it's a zero-sum game.
You're right. Yeah.
This does mean I have more rights.
Yep. That is how rights work.
If only I have the right to get married, it means more than if gay people, which, like, that may sound rude, but hey, that's business.
Uh-huh.
Yep. Yeah, that's it is business.
According to the law of average.
That's Murphy's Law.
Yeah.
Murphy. Oh, yeah.
Murphy Brown's Law.
That if a woman sounds like a man, she gets a job.
She's got the good pussy.
That's Murphy's Law.
Yeah. Get me them bitches that sound like men. Mm-hmm. That's what they got. They got the best pussy. Mm-hmm. Girls that sound like men got
the best
pussy.
What was Murphy Brown's job? She was a newscaster?
Yeah, she was.
She was a journalist.
A journalist.
Mm-hmm. And she had an abortion on the show.
On air.
That's
on
Murphy's
air?
Law, is that women aren't allowed. Women that sound like men are allowed to get abortions. Yeah.
Who worked over Murphy's pussy? Who was it in the show?
Craig T.
Nelson
Ferguson.
Craig Ferguson had that run there for a while.
Craig T. Ferguson.
Everyone was saying his show was really good.
His late night show.
Yeah.
Didn't he have pre-taped stand-up sets?
No, I think Colbert does that now.
Where it's like not a live stand-up set?
No, you do like a showcase style.
Yeah, they do like they tape the stand-up separate from the show. They do it like Craig Ferguson did that.
Craig Ferguson did that.
I feel bad for anyone that had a Craig Ferguson credit because it was like that was worthless from the get go.
Yeah.
It was like
you could say you're on TV.
Doesn't matter. It's a meaningless TV credit. I'm on CISO. I'm on Fox News. I can say I was on TV. They're both like worthless credits.
Yeah, but you're not doing stand up.
I was doing stand up on CISO. Bitch,
oh yeah, that's
and now
right.
Stars.
Oh,
which
yeah.
It's on Stars.
I think I'm owed residuals or something.
Wait,
that's
New York's
Stars?
Funniest
they
thing?
They just sold, because CISO went out of fucking business and they sold all the content. Now it's like, I mean,
Stars
I got a $600 buyout for that bullshit.
Yeah.
Stars shows that thing? New York's Funniest from 2014?
I was on TV, dude. I was in the background of that Adult Swim thing as fat.
You were on the MSG Network.
I was on the MSG Network. That's
dude,
true.
Check out my credits. Logo, Access TV.
Yeah.
Comcast Open Mic Hour.
MSG, Adult Swim at 1 a.m. in the
that's,
background.
It's,
that
having those things are
credit.
So much worse than having like
having
a real
no
credit, fucking
yeah.
credit.
That used to be a credit that people would list in D.C., Comcast. Do you remember that?
Yeah, dude, that was big.
It sucks.
We
funny
have comedians
because
from Comedy Central.
I used to harass Red Eye
HBO,
to let me go on the
Comcast.
Show as a joke, and then they had me on, and I was like, this is going to be hilarious, and then it just sucked, and then they kept asking me back, and it's like, all right, I guess I'll do it.
I'm mad I never
are
got
those
to
guys,
do Red Eye.
Are those guys funny at all?
Who?
Red Eye?
What do you mean,
that
those
guy,
guys?
Like Shaloo and...
Oh, no.
No, they're not funny.
Yeah.
Wasn't he a comic?
Yeah, but I mean, he's not funny on Red Eye. No one's funny on Red Eye.
Yeah.
It was a horrible formula for comedy.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah.
So we're going to have one comedian on, and then, you know, the editor-in-chief of... Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Reason Magazine.
The Secretary of State now...
Right.
...was sitting next to you.
Yeah.
...in the studio of Red Eye.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he was already a fucking, you know,
ambassador
to the UN.
He was an ambassador to the UN, but Bush did it... before
guys, if
the
you're
in
the betting type,
oh,
you probably
through,
want
yeah,
to
yeah.
check
tap
out
that ass ambassador.
Yeah, there you go. A slam ambassador.
Slam ambassador.
If you're the betting type, you want to check out betdsi.com. It's a sports betting website, one of the best ones out there, with a 20-year history of paying winners on time.
Oh,
or,
yes.
You know, within a reasonable amount of time.
Yeah.
With the amount of time you're supposed to be paying people.
Yeah, in a window.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what that means, but they're a great company. They've been taking bets for a while, and if you want to bet on sporting events, live events of any kind, you want to check out BetDSI.com. Right. I use it myself. I've made some money, lost some money. Hey, that's part of life, you know, taking risks. Mm-hmm. So if you're not a pussy, maybe you want to go take a risk.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
On Put your house down. That's what
that song house. Is Put your about. House down. Gamble away your children's savings.
You got to know when to hold them.
And that song's about my nuts.
Yeah. They got a fun, easy-to-use mobile app. Download the mobile app. You can bet and play anywhere. Play, bet, win.
That's right, bitch.
Check them out. You guys got some picks?
I have to say, my Russia's going to win because Putin rigged it prediction. Finally ended because of the fucking Croatians, and I'm sorry about that. Someone DM'd me and said he had to put his boy pussy up for sale to pay for the bets he lost, and I'm sorry for that. But I'm saying we got France versus Belgium about to kick off here. We're recording this on Tuesday.
So
I'm picking Belgium.
Gonna be over.
It's going to be over, so you can't. So
you can't.
But how about
this? I'm picking France because they all know how to do the shoot dance.
Yeah, you
know? That's true. It's swaggy.
Well, they're all
too.
African. France just...
They used to be all African, but now
anyway, Croatia versus England. I'm going against these fucking English fucking pasty light skin ass motherfuckers, and I'm going Croatia, keeping it in fucking southeastern Europe.
I was against it, but then I saw that video of that British soccer fan snorting a bag of coke on top of that lamp pole in
London.
That's
the thing you can bet on BetDSI.
Yeah. Yep.
Will this guy die?
Yeah,
and I'm gonna say Belgium wins the whole damn thing.
I'm rooting for England.
So those are
that
those
song
are
is too good.
Big dick locks of the week,
and also they offer live in-game wagering. Mm-hmm. So you want to
hedge on them bets
there
halfway
you go.
Through.
Go ahead, do it, and go to betdsi.com and use promo code CUM
25.
That's capital C, lowercase UM 25. And what do you get? Hit him with the details, Stavros.
Dude,
you don't remember.
You get a motherfucking
$30.
Nope.
You get a $200 match.
I don't
something
know
like that.
No, you get.
You get a credit.
You get a credit to start betting with, $40 to start betting.
I had to write this down every time because it's so fucking complicated.
Yeah, what is it?
Use promo
code. You get some good ass shit. All right,
I'll be honest with you. It's an extremely confusing promo.
Is it in your
email? It's capital C, lowercase U M.
I can look
it up. I know what it is. I was testing you guys.
Oh, no, I don't know.
You also use the promo code.
Yeah.
And it's capital C, UM25. Write this down, everybody, because it's hard to remember. Okay?
Just put in the promo code,
you
man.
Get,
that's what I do. I never
you
I don't
get
know
a
what
free
I get.
$25 wager, and then they match your deposit up to 200%.
That's right. 200%. I thought they matched up $200.
No, 200%.
Nice.
Because I fucked that up 2 weeks ago, and I think I said $200, 25%, which is not.
Other way around.
It's other way around. So, correction, and also write it down. So you know, so I know.
Look,
we'll all write it down.
Betting is not about knowing how much money you got out there. It's about taking wild-ass risks to make you feel
alive.
Look,
this show
isn't
about
small.
The truth.
No, you know? Never has.
It's been. About what feels good.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You don't need to know who your actual son is.
No.
You don't need
no.
to know who the real father
exactly.
is.
Exactly. No. He might
It feels
be...
good to think that your son is a six foot seven.
Dad.
People on my mother's side
Dad.
Were tall.
Yeah,
that's what you tell
yourself.
Yeah,
that's what I tell myself.
That sucks,
my mom.
It really
my mother's
sucks.
Side.
My cousins are all
5'11".
My cousins are all taller than me. I hate being. It just sucks. Be the shortest member of your extended family.
Yeah,
I have a cousin that's five, and I mean he's got it the worst of anybody.
Of
but
course,
I have a.
The rest of them are all like fuck. Just
are they really
over
tall?
6 feet. Yeah. I had two uncles that are like 6'4".
Yeah.
You got the little dick ass jeans.
My uncle's
but
a doctor.
I'll say this, I'm much prettier than all of them.
Yeah, there you go.
They got a pretty ass face.
Yeah. Would you take that? You'll take that.
Sure.
Over being a tall, ugly bitch?
Yeah.
My uncle is
I'm in
a doctor,
better shape now,
he...
but only because they're all like naturally athletic and then they never exercise.
Right.
And then they hit 30 and it's like, I guess I'm fat now.
Yeah. They don't care. They've lived a good life.
They've lived a much better life than I ever will.
Yeah, exactly.
I'll never be able I watch them just enjoy things like barbecues or a TV show.
No irony, not overthinking
friends.
It, having a nice time.
Yeah. Sunday fun days.
Can you imagine?
Those kind of things.
Yeah.
That'd be awesome.
Imagine holding a sparkler on the 4th of July
and
extracting something out of it.
Yeah.
And not imagining jamming it into your fucking brain.
And not putting it in front of your dick and being like, look, my dick is a sparkler. That's how I would do it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That is fun. There's nothing wrong with that.
My dick's sparkling. Yeah, whatever, though. Luckily, no one in my family is happy.
My uncle pumped my two cousins with
Ashes.
HGH.
Really?
Since they were like he was like, yeah, they're small in the growth spectrum. He's like a doctor. And now they're like both 6'5".
Really?
And he's not that tall.
So I could have been
tall?
He
like faked. Yeah, he like just. They're both like athletes now.
Fuck, dude. Yeah. I've said it before, but I'll never forgive my doctor.
Why doesn't every kid
he told
do
me
that?
I was going to be 6'4" or some shit.
I never really? Knew what I don't. I didn't have a doctor like that.
He would put you on the growth chart. I was tall for my age until sixth grade.
I never got growth charts done. There was never anything that was. There was none of that.
Yeah,
there was no doctor. I don't remember having a doctor.
It was all about percentiles.
You did not have a pediatrician that you went to?
I don't think so. No. I mean, I don't remember going to regular checkups or anything.
Really?
I would go to the doctor when I was sick. Yeah, but I don't.
Nah, my man, Dr. I don't want to say his name. I mean, whatever. Who cares?
Mangala.
Dr. Mangala. Yeah. My man always came through with the lollipops. He always checked my little ass dick. He would check it for a while, actually, but just to make sure it was healthy. And, yeah.
Dad, are we going to the doctor? Dad.
Yes. Yes, we're going.
Guys, my son
are
has
you sexually active, Adam Jr.?
My son
are
has
you sexually
a dick
active
that could
at nine?
My son has a dick that could black out the sun. I'm so proud of him. I don't know where he got that thing from.
This is the art section, New York Times. Savoring a Cosby spinoff, post-verdict.
Oh,
a different world holds firm in fans' hearts despite the tarnished legacy of its creator.
Who cares?
Right, like, what are you
talking
about?
It's a show from
about?
40 years ago.
Right, it's like, who is it? Who's sitting around
who
having debates?
Cares?
Like, can I enjoy a different world
Can
still?
I enjoy that guy flipping his sunglasses up?
Yeah.
That was a good bit.
That's so stupid.
I like that show.
Adam, you had those glasses, too, by the way. Let's not
I did. I lost them. Yeah. They came with my glasses.
And, and then you went around going to people, Dwayne Wade! You would point at them and reference
for
Dwayne
the first
Wayne
4 years of Dwayne Wade's career, I thought his name was Dwayne Wade.
Yeah.
Dwayne Wade spells his name all types of
he does.
Up.
Yeah. D-Y-D-W-Y-A.
Yeah.
Which is
D-Y-A.
Just a typo.
It doesn't.
There's no way.
His name is a typo.
That's
his
not.
Typo.
There's no way that that's like. There's. You can't make it sound
he
right.
He should have just corrected it.
Yeah.
It's fucked up.
Mm. Whatever, man. His mom wanted some fucking agency in the spelling of her son's name.
Yeah.
Or she did a typo.
For many, The Cosby Show has become unwatchable since the dozens of sexual assault allegations against Bill Cosby entered the media spotlight. It has it? Adam left the room.
I think it has. I mean, I don't want to watch that shit. It's fucking weird.
Yeah.
That guy raped he probably raped someone the night before he did The Cosby Show.
Yeah, but it's like you don't watch and consume things and like I don't.
It's hard not to think about it when you're looking at the motherfucker.
No, it's not. Not for me.
Really?
Yeah, no.
It doesn't come in. It doesn't.
No, it's just a fucking TV show. I mean, if you needed.
If he was in like a mask or something.
Okay, well, then where does it not. Where do you draw the line? I'm not saying that like, well, if you did rapes, what if a guy just got like a parking ticket? But there's plenty of bad people that are.
Yeah, for
artists.
Sure. I guess raping. And drugging.
That's specifically
people.
The line. So
I don't
if he
know
raped
if that's,
one person.
No, I don't know if that's the line. I just know that that's past the line.
I still have watched the Dr. Larry Nassar's stand-up special.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
He has a like, I don't listen to like Chris Brown or XXXTentacion or whatever the fuck.
So you're glad he's dead.
I am glad
you're going
he's
on the record saying that.
And guess what?
His music sucked.
Maybe
dick.
It was one of my shooters that did it. I don't
why
know.
Why were people so sad?
I don't know.
They're like, he had so much talent. His music
he
fucking
sucked. Yeah, I don't know, man. I get it, though. Most people in entertainment are bad people. So.
Well, it's not even that most people are bad people. It's just it's just fucking entertainment. I mean, you can separate. It's not even a discussion about separating art from the artist, but, like, it's just a fucking TV show.
Right.
You know?
I mean, maybe if it wasn't this show about what a wholesome-ass dad he was. Maybe if it was, like, some cartoon where he did a voice,
Yeah, but everything's hypocritical.
Yeah,
everything
I'm
you
just
consume
saying,
is
does
inherently
me.
Hypocritical.
What do you mean, everything you consume is hypocritical?
Well, if you wear a pair of shorts, it's made by a 4-year-old.
Exactly.
You know, like, it's like,
you
how
do
you
all
gonna,
these things. All of these things
yourself?
Are built on human suffering and exploitation that you sit there and consume.
Yeah, that's true.
I think like, having this, like, you know, oh, I can't watch the show because of what Bill Cosby did is, like, an easy way to purchase some sort of moral purity for yourself. Because it's like, you weren't watching The Cosby Show anyways. It's very easy to say, like, oh, I can't watch it anymore. It's like, well, how often were you sitting around watching The Cosby Show?
Yeah, but I mean, I get what you're saying. I mean, I don't know. I don't see the problem in not wanting to watch it because the guy raped.
Do you know what I mean?
Well, because it's like fake. I don't.
But it's not. I don't want to. I mean, I don't know. I wasn't watching it, but if it fucking came up, I'd be like, I can't. It's weird.
So if you were sitting around at somebody's house,
scary,
and they put on the Cosby Show, you like, would say, "We have to turn this off. I can't
like,
watch
I
it."
I would be like, "We're gonna watch Cosby. That's a strange choice." I would think it was a strange choice. What, you just throwing on Cosby and everyone's gonna laugh? It's weird, dude.
If it just had to be happen to come on the TV, you're sitting in a friend's house, you're watching TV, the Cosby Show comes on.
First of all, please,
you need to change
the
channel.
No, we would start making
this.
Cosby as a rapist jokes.
Sure, that's fine, but you would not be able to watch the show.
No, I wouldn't be like, my eyes wouldn't fucking hurt. But if I'm like, I'm not going to watch it in the privacy of my own home.
He's
when
an R star P I S T.
R star A P S T E R.
I'm an R star
A P I S T E R.
I love that. I love that song because he doesn't spell trap star.
No, T R A P S T R. I'm a T R A P S T R. I'm a trapster.
Trapster. Does Jeezy still make music?
I think he's retired, technically.
Yeah. I think so, but
he just dropped.
I respect him tremendously.
He dropped something recently.
Did he?
Yeah.
I remember liking Jeezy.
Me too,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah, Thug Motivation 101.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great album.
There was a summer where I went to the gym every day, and I listened to Put On for My City every single day.
There's a fucking
You really should go back to the gym, dude.
I'm going to go.
That was like...
Come on, you don't have to bring this up every fucking time.
I mean, it's one of the saddest things I've ever witnessed.
There are sadder things. There are sadder things in the world.
No, the way that janitor lady was looking at you.
It wasn't a janitor. She was a personal trainer. She was just an older woman that had a trainer t-shirt on.
Well, she had a janitor hue to her.
Yeah, she did. Do you ever see people like that? You're like, how the fuck are you a trainer?
Because it's fake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is fake.
I'm a T-R-A-P-S-T-R. There's a fucking intro to a song he did. Oh, it's so fucking funny. Where he just, they're like, if you're not rich, kill yourself. They're about to go to a strip club. He's like, if you ain't rich, kill yourself.
Have you ever seen that video, that woman doing, for a while I was really into Chug videos. Yeah, oh. Nanette. A woman doing a Patron chug, and she goes, I'm going to do this for Young Jeezy. And she's like this fat lesbian wearing a Young Jeezy t-shirt.
No, that
she
rocks.
She chugs a bottle of Patron and immediately just face plants. Like,
really?
Yeah, yeah. It's so funny. Mm,
damn.
Yeah.
So much for doing it for
do you. Do it for Young Jeezy. The funny videos are the videos of like the Wigger lesbians getting KO'd by men.
I love that.
Like, nah, what's up? Come see me outside. And just like, call the police. You just hit a girl. Call the police. You just hit a girl.
All y'all lame motherfuckers that ain't got no money, please leave and exit the building. Kill yourself.
That's how I feel about the underclass.
Me walking into a Popeyes.
Kill yourself.
Get the fuck back.
So I guess Britain's government is collapsing.
Are they?
Yeah.
Who's that guy with the fucking blonde
Theresa
mop
me?
Top?
Oh, Boris Johnson.
What's
yeah.
that guy's deal? He looks like a bitch.
He was mayor of London. He was a journalist before that. He's a piece of shit. Yeah.
He looks like a bitch. I don't know shit about British politics.
He was a Brexit guy.
Ah.
Why is it? It's falling apart
because
she can't do the Brexit.
But the Brexit?
Yeah, she can't
oh,
do the
hell
Brexit.
Yeah. Someone put me on Sky News or whatever the fuck yeah. England's news is.
The sex is horrible.
But the Brexit?
But the Brexit?
But the yeah. Brexit?
I can't fuck.
But the Brexit, my bloke?
Yeah.
I want to wear one of those fucking red uniforms, the big yeah. furry hat.
Mm-hmm.
Put that in a bitch's pussy, the Marge Simpson hat.
Mm-hmm.
Just go on British TV mm-hmm. to take the piss.
Get some. Oh yeah, take the piss.
Mm. I love to take.
I
the
love
piss.
To take the piss out of some.
I love
fucking
just
bitches.
Take the piss right into a bitch's
about
mouth.
About Vanette, and it's the guy that lives in a van.
Yeah.
Trash Canette, and it's about Roscoe. This motherfucking. Where is a receipt in that pussy?
It is a very funny bit. It is a very funny bit.
Just him like Eli from that rap battle video.
The retarded guy.
That's who your wife is fucking.
Like a bisexual, what does he say?
Just sharply inhaling.
I'm like Rosie O'Donnell with the bisexual. What does he say? That video is so funny. That was like one of my first favorites.
Where are we at? We're at a clock. An hour? All right. I hate to be the guy this week, but I gotta go to this fucking audition.
Okay. Well, listen.
So,
we
you
want to
watch
the
game?
This? I'm thinking about going back to Ass to Mouth Oria. Because if I get stuck here right now.
Yeah, you guys doing that basketball tournament?
I don't. If you're not going to do it, I don't want to.
Is it a 3-on-3? Would it, the three of us be a basketball team?
I think so. I don't know.
If you guys want to do it, I'll do it.
That would be pretty funny, but
if you don't want to do it, let's not do it.
All right. Okay.
But we're at Skankfest this weekend. The 14th, I believe, is our live show.
Yeah, on Saturday.
And then we're all doing some stand-up sets on it.
Are you doing stand-up on that Sunday show?
I don't know which one I'm on.
Frantic?
I'm not sure. But also...
Damn. Look how nice this looks. This Chinese guy in a field. That's a life I want.
That is nice.
Just be a rice farmer.
I thought that it's in water. Don't they grow rice in water?
I don't know, man. I just want to be out in a field, just my Chinese mind empty of all thoughts, waving my sword around at my plants.
What are they thinking?
Nothing. Dude, you know Louis C.K. bit about it. I was just racist, thinking that Chinese women are just thinking Chinese nonsense.
That's such a funny bit. It's so funny.
It's just nonsense. That is a great bit.
That is a good episode.
Oh, fuck. But Stav's not allowed to enjoy it because he can't stop thinking about the race.
Congratulations to Ian Finance.
That's not what I said.
Oh, yeah. Congratulations. Why are we congratulating Ian?
For being a...
Why are you bringing that up?
Being a good guy.
No, what are you congratulating him for?
For getting passed at the Comedy Cellar.
Mm-hmm. Why is that funny? Go ahead, say it.
Because he's a very bad comedian.
That's right.
All right, there we go.
You should say that with gusto next time.
All right.
Okay. I will also,
You know what I'm saying?
With busto.
How about with busto?
Like I said, I'm going to be in Charlottesville August 17th. Then Baltimore the 18th and Philly on the 19th, do a little run there. Then we are at Cleveland on the fucking 2nd, and then Boston on the 3rd in Cleveland. We're doing the live pods. That's all three of the boys. And then I am going to be in Chicago on the 21st and the 22nd of September, and Detroit on the 23rd. So
I want my head to be cut off by the cartel.
I don't think. I hope not. I hope that
by the cartel or by ISIS.
I don't know, but I feel like that would be a nice warrior's end. I'm out in my field.
A decapitation.
I'm out in my field, you know, doing dumb sword bullshit in the rice paddy.
Mm-hmm.
Remembering my days as a samurai and my dark warrior past.
Yep.
And then, you know, my son, who I have no emotional connection to, is like, "Father, there are visitors at the gate." And then I look over and it's the shogun.
Shit.
You know, and I'm like, "Go inside. Tell your mother to lock the door. I have one last thing I have to do." And then they just cut my head off.
Damn, yeah. You wouldn't fight back? You wouldn't go to the barn under the haystacks secret sword?
I'm an old warrior, dog.
Nah, you got to go out with the
sword.
Live
by the sword, die by the sword.
You can't
You got to take a guy out on your way out.
It's got to be real hard to get a clean slice. You got to go 2 whacks at least with a sword.
Samurais know how to do that, and they respect each other.
You'd respect your executioner too much to try and kill him.
Yeah, well, because, I mean, I've killed this guy's entire family. Yep. I killed his brother.
Yeah.
Samurais were all gay, right?
They were pedophiles.
They were pedophiles.
But back then, it was just called, you know, Ronin.
Wristband.
Yeah. It's called, "I love Ronin children."
Ronin. That's what that show Ronin Warriors
little boys
about.
In the ass.
Yeah. I love Ronin little boys.
Ronining their assholes.
Ronining
their asses.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, we do have to go. Nick's got a little business to take care of.
Yeah.
Fuck,
I wish I was a shogun.
You will be someday, dude.
Just drinking sake, waving my fucking blades around. You know,
isn't that reckless behavior from a shogun?
Nah, just the shogun. I've got sake. I sit in my fucking temple or whatever. Mm-hmm. I've got my goons with me, and I have this boisterous exterior, but inside I'm tortured because I realize that life isn't as satisfying as I thought it would be.
Wow.
At the you know, and I'm like I'm sort of like a King Solomon character.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know,